On your marks.
31 years on from hosting the last marathon in the county, the 2014 Donegal Marathon and Half Marathon provided a huge success. Over 800 competitors took part in the dual event, while huge crowds turned out along the route to offer encouragement and support to all the runners and walkers. Given its success, there is no doubt that the next marathon event in Donegal will not take as long to come around again. Donegal TV was there to record the event and took the opportunity before, during and after to talk to a number of people who were participating and supporting this event in Letterkenny. Danny, it's hard to believe it's 31 years ago since you were flying around the marathon here, and I've been watching you this morning. You seem as, well, you're as fit as you were and maybe as excited as you were 31 years ago.
Yeah, well, I'm not as fit as I was, but I'm probably more excited than I was. I well remember arriving at the Letterkenny IT for registration, and there wasn't as big a buzz there that day as it is now. I walked in there probably quietly with, I think it's two of the children by the hand, Dara, who's after doing the announcing there today, it's just a great day for Letterkenny Athletic Club and for Donegal and for the marathon organisers, just to get it to the starting line.
It's great to see the marathon back here again, and by the looks of things today, I think it has a great future.
You've run an amazing amount of marathons at this stage.
Well, 113 done, and hopefully today will be 114, you know, so yeah. That's...
When did it all start?
In 1988, we decided to do one marathon, myself and Joe McCusker. We decided to do the Millennium Marathon in Dublin, and just took off from there, really, you know.
Here he comes, Benny Mullen. He's certainly going to be under the 3 hours. In fact, he's going to be very close to 2:57 here. The clock's telling us. Yeah, he's just touching people's hands and absolutely delighted here. He's going to be under 2:57. Hands raised here now. Yeah, this is him. Benny Mullen from Inishowen. Number 53. Great. Absolutely delighted. Fantastic run from Benny. Wonderful display, and he's absolutely delighted. Yes, indeed. Well done, Benny. Fantastic, you must be hugely happy.
I'm absolutely over the moon, so I'm just absolutely delighted. So I'm just really, really proud to have won it, to be honest with you. Yeah. As I say, like, I haven't won ever too many races, but I always say now I've won the Donegal Marathon, so I'm absolutely delighted.
Fantastic. Yeah. And it's so long since we had one, and of course, as I said, when you're coming over the line, the last Donegal man to win a Donegal Marathon here was none other than the great Danny McDade, so that's a nice list to be on.
That's absolutely fabulous, even to be in the, I don't know, just... put up in the same honours list as Danny. It's just unreal, like, so I'm really, really proud. That's all I can say. I'm so proud to have won it. I'm delighted to have.
Yeah. Oh God, that was tough out there.
Yeah, yeah.
It was tough out there.
The second half of it must have been very tough because it warmed up considerably from the morning.
Aye, definitely in the heat. The heat's very bad, but I don't do well in the heat anyway. But there was a stretch there just past, I think, Glen Swally Graveyard. Stretched for about a mile uphill, and I had said broke most people, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Very, very tough, and it was getting warm at that stage as well, you know.
Sure.
As a local person, you know, it's very difficult to have a marathon around here without a few hills included in it.
Well, that is for sure. I thought I knew these roads, but when I went out in the cairn on a wee route recce there the last day, it looked a lot tougher, and it showed that, especially that Rock Hill Road. You know, you think it's a lot of us downhill, but it's up and down day, and you know what, it wrecks the legs, like, it really does.
Women's full marathon winner, Jolene Mullins, with me here. Jolene, many congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Tell us about it, Jolene.
It was tough, but sure, you know, you come to Letterkenny, you know, the hills of Donegal, that's what you expect, really, isn't it?
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
It was very hilly, but it was very enjoyable.
Yeah.
Jolene, tell us something about yourself and your marathon running.
I have a few marathons under the belt now, but I don't know if I get it. I don't think I find them any easier, as they don't get any easier, but stick at it.
Yeah. And Mellon, where does that name come from?
I'm from Dundalk.
Well, he was second in the ladies' event here behind Jolene. Tough race out there?
Very tough. A lot of hills.
Yeah.
And it was quite warm, actually, too.
The second half of the race particularly warm, people were saying, the men were saying that, too.
It was very warm, yeah.
Yeah.
Really sunny and exhausting.
What was the...
I found a hilly.
Well, you're in Donegal, I suppose. If you're going to find hills, you'll find them in Donegal.
Yeah, yeah.
Caroline, yourself and Jolene broke away there and had a good race between yourselves.
Yeah, well, she passed me at about mile 19 on the hill. She caught me on the hills.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
and
very
the last
tough.
Six is tough then after that.
It's very tough, yeah. Exhausting.
Kieran, the two leaders went through there in about 41 minutes for 9 miles. That's quick.
Good running, yeah. I mean, I think Gary's just off, he did a half Ironman last week, so, and he's doing
A lot of training with Maria.
Yeah.
This is Maria McCambridge coming through 6.91, Gary Cross's wife, and leading it. Michael Black, winner of the half marathon here. Michael, well done. We saw you come through New Mills, about 41 minutes for nine miles at that stage. Yeah. And we're saying to Kieran Carlin, were you just going a bit quick?
Probably went out a wee bit too hard now, but it's hard to hold back when the crowd's there and everything. The first probably 4 or 5 miles. Started to suffer a wee bit around about 5, and Gary caught me again.
Yeah.
And just ending up the back of the hill, we pushed on again. But yeah, fantastic atmosphere here today. And as I said, I wanted to go out and try and run hard and kind of hurt myself. So I done that.
Yeah.
But no, again, fantastic event here. The weather was great, got the crowds out, and I think this will be a really, really good race come the years coming up.
And fantastic in your home event here, really. It's been so long since we've hosted a major event like this to win it, Michael. It's fantastic.
Oh, yes, great. Like, you know, you've got all the people you know, and you hear your name being called as you go past there and everything. And we train these roads all the time, you know, so we know every single metre of it going past. So we know where the hard bits are, the easy bits are. And we know, suppose we have a wee bit of an advantage now, but no, it's great running here. And as I say, the weather's great, the crowd was fantastic here, which really, really you need it. And even out the road, where we thought it might be a little bit quieter, there's people all over the place. So, and big respect to the people that have to go again round there and go again. I wouldn't fancy it myself.
You just managed to beat her in the mower there, Gary. You hadn't much
just stayed ahead of her now, right? Knowing the roads, Charlie, is a bit of advantage.
I think the home advantage, certainly. Yeah. Listen, you had a great run with Michael. You really pressed him hard there.
No, I didn't. He was a different class today, and I have to say now he was well gone now, wasn't I?
Yeah. You were close to a New Mills, Gary, after 9 miles there.
I caught him at 6 miles again, but then I said, no, I just going to be a long run home, so I'm enjoying it. I have to say, it was brilliant out there. It was hard to run, waving and saying hello to so many people out there. It was fantastic. I have to say, now, fair play to the organisers and put on a great show now.
And for somebody who's been involved in the sport, to see the half marathon and marathon come back to Letterkenny after all this time, Gary?
I have to say, I would love, when I was coming in to say, I would have been loved to have gone round for another lap, but yeah. I haven't the fitness there for today, so, but it was fantastic out there. I have to say, now, fair play to the organisers, we're on a great show now, son. Okay. And it's lovely being back on home roads again and finishing coming in.
Where I started off running,
so yeah. Fantastic now.
Yeah. Maria, you looked very comfortable there right the way through.
Yeah, I just wanted a nice, comfortable, hard run and do whatever I had to do to win, and it was nice to get the win. I'm delighted with that.
Did you consider doing the full marathon today at all?
No, I've only just started training for Dublin. I'm only now officially 2 weeks into marathon training, so I had to take a bit of a break, so I got the bug back, but I need a bit of time to prepare for Dublin.
And I suppose you know these roads very well. This guy's dragged you around these roads many times in the past when you lived up here.
He sure has. I know how to take the bends now. I've been taught well.
Sean Diver here, Ross's AC, finished third in the half marathon there. Sean, very good run, and Ross's AC well represented here today.
Oh yes, kind of club starting to get more and more adults into it, and you see that today, a lot of Ross's AC shirts. They've been training since the start of the summer, and during the winter as well they're doing track sessions, so it's good enough, kind of.
I'm wrecked, but I'm just so delighted I've done it and reached the target that I wanted to reach. So yeah. Here I am. I'm just shattered now.
When did you decide you were gonna do this, Kira?
I'd say about 2 months ago. But I've always wanted to do half marathon, and I've did it today. So
yeah. I did the Derry Marathon in memory of my son. So I kept on going, and I did this marathon for my children and for my friends.
Very good.
Yes. And with Teresa McDade helped me the whole way. Thank you, Teresa.
Teresa was coaching you.
Teresa coached me the whole way. A great lady, a magnificent lady.
What do you think about Mum finishing this?
I'm very proud of her.
Absolutely.
Very, very proud of her.
Well done, ladies. Great event. Thanks a million. Well done. Well done. Nuala, have a wee chat with us here. Well done.
Thank you.
Not How bad. Do you feel after that?
Well, I was 62 the other day, Charlie, so it's not bad for now, no.
62? By God, no, that's fantastic.
There's a fast ambulance coming after me.
I'll tell you, listen, just over 2.5 hours, no, that's fantastic.
Not bad. I would hope to. We both got stitches, and Avril is a chest infection that I was running with, but
yes.
You know what? We can finish it, we can put our legs in the ground. There's everything to be thankful
fantastic.
For.
When did you decide you were going to do it?
About 3 weeks ago.
For God's sake, Nuala. You're obviously doing a good bit of walking or running, aren't you?
I did a wee bit in that now, but it's hell, the hills kill me, you know. Aye. But you know, it's not too bad. I have to go and breathe.
Some achievement. Well done, Nuala. Fantastic. Fantastic achievement here.
Absolutely amazing, Charlie. I'm so proud here as Letterkenny person today. The organising committee have pulled off something that is beyond anybody's dreams. And the way that they collaborated together, they worked 24 hours. If there was 48 hours in a day, they worked it, and it has come to fruition here today. When you see the crowds of people and the spirit, this is absolutely amazing. It's dreams come true.
Just before I go over to him now, I want you to be totally honest with me here now, Mary. Did he hold you back out there?
Absolutely. Yeah. He's been holding me back for 23 years, Charlie.
Thanks, Mary. Desi, I think we nearly stood on this exact spot here, I don't know how many weeks ago, and we were talking about this, and it was an aspiration, it was a hope, and to be honest with you, nobody was too sure how it would go. Mary summed it up perfectly there.
Absolutely, Charlie. As you say, at that stage, what we were using you for, and Shane, we're trying to get the word out, because we were worried about numbers. You're always worried because you don't know how it's going to go. There's so much work going into it. And the fact that we've 850 people participating, we sat down and met for the first time October last year. So within 11 months, we have what you see here today. And there's so many people I'd like to thank, but maybe just in a whole, just to say that people don't go, thank you, you have come out, you have supported it. We've got Jaffa Cakes on the way around, we've got sweets on the way around. All those things kept you going. People outside their house cheering you on. This is what spirit's all about, and thankfully Donegal has shown it to the maximum today.
Charlie Collins for Donegal TV at the half and full marathons here in Letterkenny.